So, white dots. So, it's almost like a guess who. Say, you know that game where you say, have they got a beard? Have they got glasses? And you pick out which one it is by these features. So in the white dot syndromes that cause white dots, there are three distinct conditions. One is called birdshot. Birdshot is a way of killing birds. It is pellets of lead which spread out in such a way that the pellets are relatively small and spread out. Birdshot, there's vitiligenous dots in that they are yellow. So they are not allowed to be pigmented. If they are pigmented, it is not birdshot. It cannot be birdshot. They're meant to be yellow. And you get these dots orientated towards the posterior pole, almost as if they're, you can see how the shotgun was discharged. There is a specific HLA linkage, the vast majority, but not exclusively women. There is some vitritis, never anterior uveitis, and those dots. The other one that can be separated out is called serpiginous, which means in Latin, snake-like. And that is like two snakes, if you like, top and bottom in both eyes. It's meant to be bilateral, coming out of the optic nerve, meant to be attached to the optic nerve, and they come around again in pincer movement on the fovea. You don't get much, if at any, in the way of inflammation, because the main differential diagnosis is toxoplasma, and that would cause huge amounts of vitreous inflammation. So you're not meant to get very much vitreous inflammation at all, if any. But it does advance slowly and inexorably. Some people think you should immunosuppress them always to prevent it from spreading, but it has been found that the amount of immunosuppression you need is massive. You need a huge amount to make a difference. And the third one is a condition called AMPI. Big blodges up to the size of the optic disc of upturned plates, yellow lesions, massive amounts of vitritis, both eyes. The patient will tend to be young, and it is preceded by a flu-like illness. So a flu-like illness, they feel unwell, and you look in their eyes and you see this. They can also have liver abnormalities. And the other interesting thing is that if they have headaches, you need to admit them straight away to give them intravenous steroids, or they might die, as it is could be a sign of cerebral vasculitis. So AMPI is one of the few white dot syndromes that can kill people. So we've already reduced the field. So now comes the spectrum. At the very mildest end, because they sort of run into each other in a confusing way. On the mildest end, you have acute idiopathic blind spot enlargement syndrome. It is young, myopic women who come in nervous about a little bit of photopsia. They see a little bit of, sometimes they say, which you can only find on doing visual fields. The treatment doesn't exist anyway. Even if you wanted to treat it, you wouldn't. Let's move it up a notch. So then we've got MUDES, which stands for unilateral, little dots, very difficult to see. They come, they go. Do you treat it? No. What you do is you reassure them. But then there's another one as well, which is called Azur. So the key word is the cult, because you cannot see anything wrong the vast majority of the time. People come photopsias. Again, it's all the same crossovery thing. Photopsias, young, tend to be female. A lot of them are myopic. A bit of photopsias. You take a look, you can't see anything. You do a field test and you see that there's a bit missing, a fundus autofluorescence, and that can show it up quite nicely. If you do it on the blue spectrum, it shows up really nicely. To recap that, it's a spectrum between essentially photopsias, RAPDs, young, female, unilateral things in which the photoreceptors, by some unknown process, don't function properly and then die, and in the case of azure, leaves you with pigmented areas. Moods is part of the same spectrum as well, because commonly with moods, you, if you did a field test, you would also see an enlarged blind spot, which is peculiar. And then you have the spectrum of doing something, which on the one hand, if it, these dots, if they're concentrated at the macula, they're called PIC. And if they are further out, it is called multifocal choroiditis with panuveitis. If the dots are concentrated peripherally, MCP. If the dots are concentrated at the fovea, PIC. What does PIC stand for? So essentially, these are pigmented dots. PIC doesn't have vitritis, whereas MCP does. In fact, P stands for panuveitis. It is thought that it is purely the size of the lesions and extent that determines this. Beautiful, lovely. And everybody enjoy the white dot syndromes, for they are like the Wild West before the states were organized.